I cannot believe it. We are at the season finale of season 5 of Queen Sugar. And this was definitely an interesting, detailed, nuanced, and incredible season finale. Let's talk about it. As every episode has from the beginning of this season, we start off with Ralph Angel and family. Ra, Darla, and Blue are preparing to make the trek to DC. In recent episodes, they decided that the best thing for Blue was to allow him to attend this prestigious private school in Washington, DC, after quite heated debates and arguments around Blue actually moving to DC to stay with Darla's parents and go to this exceptional school. They decided that that would be the best thing for him. He really wants to do it, and it will allow for him to really grow intellectually and personally, as well as establishing strong professional networks and giving him a leg up in life just from his proximity to just more affluent things. And ultimately, I think that they made the right decision. Of course, this isn't a decision that they did lightly, because that would mean that Blue is moving away from the all family that he really knows. While he does know Darla's mom or Darla's parents, he doesn't know them as well as he knows Aunt Vi, and he knows, you know, Charlie and Nova. He's grown up with them, even when Darla was struggling with her drug addiction and Ralph Angel was in prison. Blue had Vi, and Blue had, you know, Charlie, Nova, and Ralph Angel's father to act as surrogate parents for him while his parents were, you know, on their journeys and dealing with what they had to deal with. And that is why Vi is struggling so hard with this decision. In this episode, we see her and Ralph Angel are still at odds after some very heated words were exchanged in the last episode. To be honest, both of them really hit below the belt. Ralph Angel made a dig at her never having her own kids, and then Vi made a dig at Ra not being anything that his dad would be proud of, and saying that, oh, you know, his father would be ashamed of him, and just really making low blows. So in this episode, we see them not talking, and Vi explains that Ralph Angel isn't speaking to her, when I think that she's also keeping her distance as well. And it's unfortunate, because they have such a really great bond. Again, Vi has been such a huge support system for Ralph Angel, and I can see how that has tricked her into believing that she kind of is Blue's parent. Because at the end of the day, Ra is right. Ra and Darla are his parents. They have to be able to make decisions. And while Vi can disagree with the decisions that they are making, she still has to respect the fact that she is not the parent. And they are family. They are parents. And they have stepped up, assumed the mantle, and have been doing a great job as of late with Blue. So the fact that Vi has her heels dug in about this one and really decided to go scorched earth with Ra and completely sacrifice their relationship, I'm just like, girl, you're doing a lot, especially in these times where we see the entire season play out over the course of the start of quarantine and the pandemic. And it's like, this is not the time to be alienating yourself from your family. Thank God Hollywood has snapped out of what he had going on. He's getting back into his swing of things. His personality is coming back. He's less depressed. He's more hopeful. There was a few episodes this season after his mom's passing where we really saw Hollywood fall into a very dark place. And I wasn't sure if he was going to be able to climb out of it, but he has. And thank God that he has, because now he's in a really great space to be able to call Vi on her BS and call Vi in this episode in particular and tell her, you need to apologize to Ralph Angel. What you said was not kind, whether you believe it to be true or not. It was not kind. It was not helpful. It was unnecessary. And at the end of the day, y'all are family, and you have to respect that that's his parent. Ra is his parent. And he also really put into perspective that Vi is looking at it like her pain. And yes, she's going to miss Blue, but she's honestly trying to usurp the fact that Ra is not happy about the decision either. He is not functioning like a complete depressed person in reference to like what you stereotypically would see when someone is depressed, but Ralph Angel is moving a little bit slower. He's a lot more calm. You can tell that he's like processing that he's sending his son away and he's struggling with that. And I love that Hollywood is able to explain that to Vi in a way that she can understand and she can put better perspective to it, so that hopefully when we see season 6 pop off and hopefully they start to actually interact, you can see her come to Vi with a little bit more grace and understanding and not necessarily just putting herself and her feelings first. The bulk of Vi's story in this season finale really centered around where she's at with Ralph Angel. We do get a little bit of moments of her talking with Charlie and catching up in that regard. She's still unaware of the fact that Charlie had COVID and it was so bad. And now that we're like on the tail end of this, I like the way they allowed Charlie to handle this and not necessarily lean on who she typically would or who we hope that she would in reference to being able to bring Davis back into the equation, but specifically to Vi. Aside from the large drama with Ralph Angel, her diner gets to open back, I think, to 50% capacity, so we start to see progress in that regard. But the bulk of her story in the finale is really centered around what's going to happen with her relationship with Ralph Angel, and we kind of get left on a cliffhanger because at the end of the episode she decides that she will call Ralph Angel, but we don't actually get to see the call happen. So I'm looking forward to, in the premiere of season 6, that be one of the first orders of business for Vi. And touching on Ralph Angel a little bit still, I am very proud of him. He's had to make very hard decisions in reference to leading his family through this pandemic, through quarantine, through the loss of, you know, their farming season and not being able to bring crop to harvest, sending Blue to this prestigious school. He has truly stepped up as the leader in his household. And there was a time where you could not count on Ralph Angel to do anything. And to think about the last 10 episodes and how we've seen this young Black man show up for his family, it's just beautiful to see. I think it's chef's kiss that by the end of the episode, spoiler alert, Darla announced that they are pregnant. I just thought that was chef's kiss because Ralph Angel has earned it. And it's not like, oh, you get a prize baby at the end. I'm not trying to say that, but I just think that he's now going to be able to shift out of this space of like sadness around Blue going away to go to school and get excited about something and really feel like proud of who he is and how he's showing up for his family. Because honestly, he's in a space right now where he's had to make the tough decision to send Blue away, and that doesn't feel rewarding right now. Like, it doesn't necessarily feel like you're doing the right thing when you're in pain from missing somebody. But with a new baby on the way, it's like that can help him feel like you're making the right decisions, even when it's hard, even when it feels like a big sacrifice, even when everything is telling you that you don't want to do it or you shouldn't do it, you are making the right decision. And I just thought I kind of felt it towards the middle of the episode. I'm like, something's gonna come up. I think they need to get pregnant or something's gonna happen. I'm just happy that it happened so soon and we'll be able to see them walking into season 6 preparing for a new baby and growing their family. That's so exciting. I absolutely love how they handled Charlie's story in this episode. If you missed it, I did a Charlie and Davis comeback destined to happen video where I talked about them trying to plant the seeds. And when I say them, the creatives or the writers planting the seeds for Davis and Charlie to reconnect. I didn't expect for it to happen so soon, but we were starting to get little Easter eggs around that's what Charlie was thinking, and she started to imagine what the life could look like after Davis showed up and showed out for her when she contracted COVID and really just was everything that she needed and more. And in this episode, we really get to see her go through the process of what does that look like. She consults Aunt Vi, she consults Darla, and she really just, you can see her thinking about all of the pros and cons and weighing this decision of, is this a road that she wants to go down? And I thought that this was a really great conversation to have, because before this, I would have thought like there's no coming back for Davis, right? Like, I never thought about her and Davis reuniting until after he showed up in this way for her. And then we get to see in this episode her actually questioning certain things. And after she goes down the line and gets advice, in which Vi gives her beautiful advice about, you know, Davis just being a stupid man. He made a stupid mistake, but he's not a bad person. And then Darla not wanting to give advice specifically about the relationship, but reminding her that it's about whatever she wants to do, or whatever, whoever she's in a relationship with, whatever they want to do, because they are the ones who have to wake up to each other, have to love each other each day, and it's not really about what anyone else outside of them thinks. And she speaks from experience with that, and it's just so sage in reference to what she imparts on Charlie. But then we actually get to see Charlie have the conversation with Davis, and she gets to ask real questions, and he answers in a way that's not scapegoaty or not, like, you know, not taking accountability, which was so weird but refreshing to see, to watch this man stand in his truth and talk about how the decisions that he made in reference to fathering children outside of their marriage, the infidelity, the lack of support, the lack of acknowledgement of how amazing Charlie was on a consistent basis, all came from a place of disdain that he had for himself. And when I'm like watching Davis in this scene, all I could think about is, like, this man literally did the work. In the last 4 years, he has done the work of going inside and really trying to figure out, why does he do the things that he do? What made him do what he did? Does he want to continue to do these things moving forward? How does he want to feel? How does he want to make the people that he loved feel? Like, I feel like, I don't know who your therapist is, but they need a bonus, Davis. Golly. Every single question that she had, he answered. And he just did so in the way that was just so honest and raw. And I was just like, I'm still processing it, because I'm just like, do guys really do this? Where are they at? Where's the factory pushing out the guys having real honest conversation and being accountable, child? Needless to say, I'm here for the reunion that we get to see. Charlie is going to step out on faith. She's going to go with her heart, and she's going to give Davis a try, or another try. And I'm actually excited for it. Before, 2 episodes ago, I was not feeling it. I was just like, I feel like y'all are trying to set me up. I don't know if we can forgive him. I don't know if he can come back from this. And apparently he can, because now I'm on board. Just in them having this real honest conversation, I'm 100% on board. There was a moment there where I wasn't sure if Micah had a problem with it, because he finds out that Charlie got sick, and then as soon as she tells him that his dad was the one who helped her, he just hangs up the phone like, I'm on my way. And I'm like, oh wait, is this about to be an issue? But we see towards the end of the episode that it's all good, they're all together. And it's interesting because it feels like a very full circle moment, because the very end of this episode where we see Charlie, Davis, and Micah, you know, going through photos that he's taken at some of these protests, it feels like episode 1, before any of the fallout, before any of the news breaks. And it just feels like a family that loves each other and works. So I'm excited going into episode 6 to see where we're going to land with the reuniting of Charlie and Davis, and if they can put their family back together. And I cannot finish this episode breakdown without talking about the most tense part of this episode, which is the conversation between Nova and Calvin. She actually brings to his attention the story of the young man who Calvin actually contributed to the breaking of his back in the police brutality situation, police harassment, racially charged police harassment in the beginning of Calvin's career. And my heart goes out to Nova, because you can tell that she's really in love with Calvin, and this breaks her. This goes against everything that she stands for. This goes against, like, being in love with a person who is capable of this, whether in the past or not, is something that she is deeply struggling with, and we see her struggle throughout the episode. And she does not shy away from these tough conversations. She doesn't run completely, which is interesting, because I don't know if I could do it. I feel like I would have probably, like, left or put him out, and that would have been that. Because it's like, what do you say? What do you say to your white lover, fiance, well, soon to be fiance, because they were talking about marriage, when you find out One, he's a cop, and you find out that he participated in the beating that broke the back of a young black boy off the strength of just, they picked this little black boy because they were racist cops. The boy didn't do anything. He hadn't, like, committed a crime. Like, this is fiction, and I'm, like, sitting here flabbergasted by what do you say to that? Like, is there anything that you can say to that? So the fact that Nova is even still there and having a conversation and even still there and trying to process in the home with him, because for me, I would just, it'd have been a wrap. And maybe it's because I got to do a little bit more healing, but it would have been a wrap. I did appreciate at one moment in the episode where Nova expresses to him how she wants to scream, how she wants to go off, like how she wants to get violent, like all of the things that are brewing inside of her. I feel like she has been so transparent and so candid, and I think that this was needed. I think this is a very different part of the conversation around, I don't know how to say this without it sounding weird, so let me know in the comment section down below if it doesn't make sense to you. I am not saying this statement, okay? I'm just saying that I think that this is a backdoor way of how they're having a conversation around Blue Lives Matter, which is something that popped up after, you know, the big push behind Black Lives Matter. And then, of course, Black Lives Matter sparked people saying All Lives Matter and then Blue Lives Matter. I think that what's happening right now with Nova and Calvin is basically a backdoor way of having a conversation about Blue Lives Matter in reference to, you know, the actual cops that are doing these heinous acts. Are they human? Are they, should they be forgiven? How do we hold them accountable? If that was your loved one, what would you do? And you get to see Nova struggle with all of that. Because even in, it's one part in the episode where she says that she is ashamed of herself for wanting to protect him. And I just felt like this was so powerful. I actually have a really great friend of mine whose father is a police officer, and this is a conversation that we had early on when a lot of the protests started to break out last year, and she was very worried about, you know, she was very worried about her father. And, you know, he is a cop, and in the moments where, you know, there's tons of conversations around defund the police and there's tons of just anti-police conversations, she really put into perspective for me of, you know, well, my father as well as my sister, they are police officers, and I love them and I care about them. And until you're in that space and you happen to love one of those people who are on that other side, it you don't necessarily get to see the conversation or see it from that angle. So I thought that the conversation around Nova and Calvin and where do they go from here, where does their love go from here, how do we hold him accountable, I felt like this was Queen Sugar's way of having this conversation, and specifically around him also being a white cop. So I don't necessarily know what that's like. Like, my friend, her, of course, sister and father are black police officers, so that's also adds a different layer to it. But what about these, you know, white cops who are doing these things? Can we ever forgive them? Like, how does that work? And at the end of the episode, we see Calvin try to atone and take accountability for this thing that he's done by turning himself into internal affairs, but we don't necessarily know where that's going to go, so we're gonna have to wait to season 6 to see what happens next. And honestly, I don't have any answers. I'm still pissed at Calvin. I just kind of give Nova a little bit of props in reference to taking time to process it and try to think through it thoroughly and pray on it and all of that great stuff, because I'm just infuriated and I just kind of stopped there. And it takes a very evolved person to be able to go to the levels in which we see her go in this episode. And there you have it. That is my episode 10, the season finale for season 5 of Queen Sugar. I hope you all enjoyed this season as much as I did. I thought it was absolutely beautiful. One of the things that I love about Queen Sugar is I feel like their episodes are shot like movies. And I definitely felt like this finale felt like a movie while I was watching it. It was so beautiful and cinematic, and the pacing was great. Like, I really, really enjoy Queen Sugar as a show. Let me know what was your favorite part of this season in the comment section down below. Let me know any of your thoughts about my video. I'm Erica Vane, and I post new videos every single day covering the hottest television shows, films, and entertainment news. You should join the tribe by hitting subscribe. I promise you're going to love it here. There's so much more to come. And you could check out my full Queen Sugar playlist here if you want to catch up on anything, or if you're looking for something new to watch now that Queen Sugar has ended for this season. I have two show suggestions for you here. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.